Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for your love and support as always. I'm so grateful. If to those the first time you are coming across this channel and you are seeing my face for the first time, this is Agatha Progress channel and I come across your way every blessed day. In this channel, we bring the best of news to your doorpost through this channel. And in this channel, correction is highly needed. Thank you very much once again for always tuning in. I am so grateful. Now, here is the video of the day. I don't really know how you felt about this video, but your opinion is highly needed in the comment section. Now, let's go and watch the video together.
So my beloved wonderful family, today update is another one. Again, we have our leader Mazina the Kanu on board. He have a message to drop to the world, but before then I just want us to trash out some of these issues that we know that they are affecting us generally. At times I begin to imagine, if you can see what is on in that paper, he said insecurity, why US others can't help Nigeria. Do you really think that the write-up is truth? Do you think that about this insecurity process or the level at which the country is today, will US really help? Like, there are a lot of killings, a lot of kidnapping in Nigeria, but nobody is talking about it. Those are some of the words that our leader Mazina the Kanu is about to say in this video. He really expatiates on them very well, because I see that at times some part has been cheated in Nigeria. Why the US, the British, why are they not saying anything about it? Even the security agent they brought to Nigeria, why are they not saying anything about it? I think why they can't help Nigeria, because one thing I have come to discover is that US don't negotiate with terrorists. But Nigeria, they are good at that. Nigeria can pay a lot of ransom. They don't even care to negotiate with them. If you see how much they have spent on Bandit and Boko Haram for 1 year, if you see the budget, you will weep for Nigeria. Just take a look at what happened in Tollgate. How everything was just wiped under the carpet. At least I begin to imagine, what are they really doing? Is it that they seek attention, or they just want to fly in and prove to people that they back up Nigeria? Meanwhile, they are not. Any little thing, Nigeria government will just run to them, as if they can help. Will they really help? Are they really helping the situation in Nigeria? What do you think that these people they are up to? Because I know that their blood generates the corruption we are talking about, but it's just that their own, they do it in a very civilized way, like in a very matured way, that you will not even know they corrupt. But they are taking their corruption from their own country. They go outside to other countries and corrupt the country and bring the money, bring the resources back to their country. But in Nigeria, how do we exchange the corruption? We do it right in our home. These people, they know that sharing the country is the right thing that we have to do right now, because they know that we are too much to be rude under one man. We need to go our separate ways. We are too much. They discourage us and they bring in this division that we are seeing today. But it's just that we don't have to be blaming them at all times. At 60, we don't still know what we want. That means we have to ask other questions. What we are and what we are seeing, they are all leaders of yesterday. They are not living in our past. We just want division. Let everybody go their separate way for peace to reign. This right now is beyond the world. It's not something that they will say, let us sit down and talk about it. It's too late for them to come in right now, because what they want, their own motive, is never for us to go our separate ways. They still want us to remain under that one Nigeria, of which is not going to work. We need to protect ourselves. We need to go our separate ways. We need to share the gari and let everybody go. Shikina, that is just what we want. Why is it that they maltreat some people in some areas and nobody is talking about it? And when it's only in the northern area, everybody is talking about it. Everybody is justifying about it. That is why our leader Mazina the Kanu keep crying and keep protecting us. So I have to drop the video for you guys to watch. Let us hear his own side. And don't forget to drop your comment as well.
They are being massacred. None of you work for the EFIC. None of you work for Anang. None of you work for even a John and other ethnic groups that made up Eastern Nigeria. None of you ever work for us. We died that your useless Nigeria may be won. And today, all of us are dying. But one day, weeping must come to an end. We have decided not to weep anymore. We have decided not to cry anymore. We have decided not to complain anymore. We have decided not to petition anybody anymore. But I'm sure by the time the Fulani Janjaweed gets exactly what they're looking for in our land, the world will be forced to intervene. This very security outfit is very, very proactive. It has been set up that very way. We are going to confront every enemy. We are going to confront anybody who will come to kill us. Because trust me, they will come. As somebody once said, there is a method in our madness. We will draw their army down into our land. Their flanks will be opened up. Their villages will be occupied by bandits and terrorists that they themselves created. That by the time they are done and we have sent them packing from Biafra land, they will have no home to go to. All of them don't have no home to go to. The zoo is finished. And there is nothing anybody can do about it. We are not going to keep on weeping. This very evening, we want to remind the world that Fulani terrorists massacred us at Nimbo. They killed us at Ozowani. They came to my house with uniforms and killed over 28 people, as a result of which my parents died. These people will continue killing. All of you are witness to what happened in Obibo. We cannot allow such to happen again. And any governor who foolishly sides with the zoo to inflict death, pain, and suffering upon our people will be held personally responsible, himself and his family. Himself and his family. And all of you that participated or encouraged the slaughter of the innocent at Obibo, you all will be held accountable at the right time. You cannot go free, including Wike. You cannot go free. I assure you, I'm saying it so that the world can hear. So that the day you meet your nemesis, they will know that I announced it live on air. If they want us to go to ICC, we go to ICC. Any court in the world they want us to go to, we'll go there. But Wike cannot go free. Not now, not tomorrow, not ever. And the same goes for any other idiotic governor that may want to kill our people. It will no longer happen. In the coming days and weeks, people are going to come out to protest. This very Eastern Security Network will provide much needed security for protesters across Biafra land. I repeat, they will provide security for peaceful protesters across Biafra land. Any idiot in uniform that wants to dare us, you're more than welcome to do so. But you will bear the brunt and the consequences will be very, very dire, I assure you. I assure you. Those of you that bore witness to what happened at Zaki Biam, at OD, Emene, Obibo, Isiama Farugu, in Aba, in Atumpo, must know that we cannot allow such senseless state-sponsored massacre of the innocent to continue. We can't allow it. We will never, ever allow it. Therefore, I am placing the United Nations on notice, the EU, British government, the US government, that wherever the Nigerian army goes in again to massacre innocent people, we are going to retaliate. We will retaliate. Obibo will be the last time any sitting governor anywhere will give the order for innocent people to be killed. Should that happen again, that governor will die. I am saying it, so you cut out this very clip and send it to the ICC so they can have it there with them. And all these criminals, all these murderers, we shall meet them there. Should the need arise. You cannot go about killing innocent people and you expect them to do nothing. It is impossible. Absolutely impossible. It cannot happen. We have come to die for what we believe in. We have come that we may be free. The zoo called Nigeria was created.
Oh my word. That is all about this video. Hope you do enjoy this video. Please, if you know you haven't subscribed to this wonderful channel, do well to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you very much for always tuning in. And if you watch the video to this very end, you are the best. See you again in my next post shortly. See you when I see you. Bye-bye.